Hey guys, welcome back. In today's code review, we're going to look at a project which is a small CRUD-based API. The project is open source, so I'll leave a link in the description below. We'll be refactoring some routes, some controller methods, and we'll be implementing an advanced form validation. So make sure you stay until the end. Okay, so let's start off by looking at the API routes file. Okay, so the first thing I noticed was structuring the actual routes. When you structure your routes, the route should be in plural, and your controllers should be singular. Like this is perfectly fine. The same goes for users, regions, and comments. Another thing that can be changed in this routes file is the resource method on the route. If you use an API resource controller, your resource method should be API resource instead of just resource. Now, the difference between an API resource and a normal resource is your API resource in your controller, it automatically excludes the edit and the create functions, which are normal resource methods. Okay, so the next thing I want to show you is back in the comment controller in the show method. Now, instead of receiving the ID and manually looking up the comment, we can type in the comment variable and rely on route model binding to get the comment for us. And then we can basically remove this manual check over here. The next thing I would remove is this try catch block. Because we're catching a generic error and returning a standard response, we can rely on Laravel to do its thing and handle the exception with the exception response for us. So we don't need to manually send a standard response. So we can basically take our response and remove it from the try catch block. Now, a better way or a more standard way for sending a response is by using an API resource. So let's create one for this comment. We'll call php artisan make resource comment resource. Then what we can do is we will return a new comment resource, and then we'll pass in the comment we've received. Laravel is also smart enough to know that this requires a 200 response, so we don't need to send the code manually. We can basically then remove this line of code. Okay, so now you can see the show method is a lot shorter and it works exactly the same. Okay, so before we jump into the last big section, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, if you want to see more of this type of content, then yeah, subscribe and remember to turn on the notifications. Okay, so let's look at the user store method. Now, the developer manually checks whether the user exists using the email and the type received from the request. Now, we can do all this in a custom form request. So let's create one. PHP artisan make request, and then we'll say store user request. Oh. Okay, now in our request, we can say our rules should be the name should be required, and let's say our email and password. So email is required, type is required, and password is required. We can just add another requirement for the email to say that it needs to be an email. Now, there might be some other requirements for this project, but at the moment, I'm going to leave it as required because I don't know what the other ones are or if there is any. All right, I'm just going to clean up this method. We'll return a Boolean. And we'll return default true because we're not going to do authorization in this form request. Okay, so now in order for us to do this check in the request, we'll need to set up a custom validation rule. And we can do this by calling php artisan make rule, and we can say user exists. And now we can add our validation requirement under the email to say new user exists. Okay, now let's go ahead and configure this validation rule. So the custom validation has got a passes method. This is where you check to see whether it exists or not, and then it returns a Boolean. Okay, so let's just go ahead and type in our return type so we can make sure that we send back a Boolean. Now the passes method receives two parameters, attribute and value. Attribute is the name of the attribute we're checking, which is email in this case, and the value would be the actual email that's being sent to check. Okay, so this is the conditional that was in the user controller to check whether it exists. Okay, so let's import our user class. and then we assign the user to a variable. Now, the email is not going to be from the request anymore. It's going to be this value. So let's replace that with this value. Now, in our second where clause, we need to use the type from the request in combination with the email to check whether this user exists or not. By default, we only have access to the email attribute because that's what we defined in our form validation. So we need to tell this rule to also implement the data aware rule. This will give us access to all the data within the request. And by implementing this data aware interface, we need to add some properties, like a protected data property, which is by default an empty array. And we also need to implement a set data method. Okay, now instead of the request, we've got access to all the data within the request, and we can access that by calling the data property, this data property, and we're calling the type. Okay, and now we can check whether the user exists or not by saying if it is null, meaning it doesn't exist, the user, then we can return true, meaning that this validation passes, meaning that it's okay for the user to be created. Or else, if it doesn't, then we can just return that this validation should fail. And then we can also update our validation message to say this user already exists. Okay, and that should be it for our custom validation rule. Now back in our user controller, we can now ask Laravel to inject the store user request instead of the default request class. Okay, so now we can basically remove these lines of code because this else statement is redundant because it just returns an okay message, which we're going to return anyway after we create the user. So we can remove this. And because we've checked in the store user request whether the user exists or not, this whole if else statement is now redundant. So let's take our user create code and remove it like this. And as you might know by now, I'm going to remove this whole try catch block because again, we've got a generic error with a standard response, which Laravel can do for us. And let's tidy this up. Now, the next thing I'm going to remove is this line of code. Now, instead of newing up the user, we can rely on dependency injection by type hinting a new user variable like this. And now we can remove this line of code. Okay, so let's just tidy up all this commented information to make our method look a lot better. Okay, saving your user like this by relying on dependency injection and assigning the properties individually is perfectly fine. That's one way of doing it. If you prefer a different way of doing it, another way, for example, would be if you call the create method on the user model and then assign each required field from the request like this. Whichever method you decide to use is perfectly fine. There's no right or wrong answer here. I'm just going to stick with the save method for now. Okay, and so the last thing I would change in this method is the response. So instead of, again, returning a normal response, I would return a user resource. Okay, so let's create a user resource by PHP artisan make resource, and we'll call it user resource. All right, and then we can return a new user resource, and we'll pass in our user. All right, and as you can see, our method is a lot cleaner, a lot shorter, and it still works exactly the same. And that's it for this episode, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.